the main event, and it's certainly a very unusual main event, an eight-man tag team match. Dirk Myers, Kerry Brown, Dynamite Kid, Great Gamma, against Bruce Hart, Davey Boy Smith, Keith Hart, and Robbie Stewart. We passed the 10-minute mark. That's Kerry Brown down on the deck. Robbie Stewart going after him right here. This is one fall, 1 hour time limit. Oh, there's a head knocker. Has he got him? The tag, and it's Bruce Hart. Bruce Hart going after Brown now. Look at this. Great big slam. Elbow drop to the throat, and this team has been changing quickly and has dominated the fight. It's Keith Hart. Mule kick, beautifully done from close range. It's a one, and it's broken up by Dynamite. And Brown is jammed into that corner, whether he wants to be there or not. Good hip toss. Whoops, broken up. There's the tag. Here's Robbie Stewart. Robbie Stewart against Kerry Brown. Big slam coming up. Stewart goes up top. Oh, great big elbow smash to the chest. Wow. Tremendous action in this fight. And so far, oh man, he hit that turnbuckle. Gotta be hurt. One. I think Stewart had him. There's the tag with Davey Boy Smith. Headbutt. Down goes Brown. Such rapid. Oh, wow. That separates the leg bone from the hip bone. You people down the line, the stars of Stampede Wrestling will be in Henna on October 12th, in Red Deer on the 14th, Lethbridge the 15th, in Saskatoon on the 19th, Swift Current the 21st, Medicine Hat the 22nd. Got that? People watching in Henna, Red Deer, Lethbridge, Saskatoon, Swift Current, Medicine Hat, the stars of Stampede Wrestling will soon be there. And now we switch to the 50-minute mark of this fight. Oh, I wish you could have seen the whole thing. What a fight. The eight-man tag, Myers, Brown, Dynamite, and Gamma against Bruce and Keith Hart, Smith and Stewart. And that's Robbie Stewart on the far side against Duke Myers. And Stewart has taken a bad pounding over the last 50 minutes. Or 5 minutes or so, I should say. The referee, Cedric Hathaway, has really drawn the ire of the crowd. Keith Hart fighting now with John Foley right smack beside us, and I'm kind of trapped in here. Now Keith Hart gets a couple of swipes in, and Dynamite bangs him into that press table. This is getting a crazy place to be. Foley really banged around by Keith Hart. Meanwhile, back in the ring, it's still Robbie Stewart taking quite a pounding. Robbie Stewart against Kerry Brown. We're shaken up by that one. But Hathaway's refereeing has been from hunger. J.R. Foley sitting beside me. He's really taking a pounding. We're nearing the 55-minute mark. It's one fall, 1 hour. Stewart needs help. Here comes Myers. Robbie Stewart has got to make a tag. The crowd, very upset with a referee, chanting, "We want a ref."
I'll give you one, buddy.
This is the great Gama. Robbie Stewart's got to get out of there. Pulls him down. One, two, and it was broken up by Brown.
Get him out of there, man. What is that?
Yellow card being shown to Kerry Brown. I don't imagine he cares. Him? No. Again, it's Kerry Brown. Here's Gama. No tag at all. Stewart needing to make the tag. Nearing 55 minutes. There's a legitimate tag, and it's Kerry Brown. You're watching an eight-man tag. Myers and Brown, Dynamite and Gama. Against Bruce and Keith Hart, Smith and Stewart. There's Stewart. Can he make the tag? Brown won't let him. Stewart has gone, 8 or 9 minutes now. Duke Myers. Just about 54 minutes gone. Now just a minute. In the meantime, Stewart has dropped over the top. The crowd goes nuts because, again, Hathaway missed a vital tag. Of course, Hathaway did not see Robbie Stewart going over the top rope, which is illegal. Stewart is caught between Dynamite and Brown over there. Left. 5 minutes left. Stewart has got to make that tag, or this one, or this bout could soon be over. That dynamite is rough. Oh. Tag, Kerry Brown.
Aren't my boys a great team, Ed?
Your boys, I beg your pardon?
Aren't my boys a great team?
Debatable, my friend, debatable.
It's one of the better modern moves of wrestling I've seen lately. Yeah.
Kerry Brown, Duke Myers, Dynamite and Kiyama. Keith and Bruce Hart, Smith and Stewart. Stewart drives him off the ropes. 4 minutes left. Both Gama and Stewart shaking up. Whoops. One, two, it was broken. Boy, Stewart has been in there by himself for 13, 14 minutes. Now we've got 3 minutes. Here's Dynamite. Cover one, two, that's all. Tag, and it's Gamma.
3 minutes to go.
Over the top. Cover one, and it was broken up by Keith Hart. 2 minutes, 15 seconds to go. Stewart has one, two. He's been barely hanging. 2 minutes. Shake it up. Dynamite will be driven into, I believe, whoops. Yes, there it is. Into Gamma, down they both go. Brown and Myers collided. And Brown is thrown over top. The referee didn't see it. Now we have how much? There's the sleeper. 1 minute to go. Sleeper. Keith Hart may have him. Keith Hart may have won this fight. Keith Hart has got him. Keith Hart has got him. 45 seconds to go. 45 seconds to go. Just a minute. Just a minute. There was 30 seconds to go. Foley, you rang the bell. Foley rang the bell. Foley rang the bell. He rang it with about 40 seconds left. What are you doing?
Saved by the bell, wasn't he?
He rang the bell.
He was saved by the bell.
45 seconds left. Well, I don't know what to tell you.
Tell me.
Obviously, obviously some of the combatants don't want to end the fight. But a controversial ending, and the bell was definitely rung by J.R. Foley.
Hey, Foley rang the bell!
Well, a wild crowd has been evacuated from the building. This is roughly, what, half an hour after the match is over? J.R. Foley.
Yeah, Ed.
You hit the bell. There were 45 seconds left, and Gamma was gone.
60 minutes, Ed, 60 minutes.
No, it was 59-15.
We do not cheat, and none of my boys cheat.
Right.
Ask them.
Right, you just told a lie. 59-15.
Yeah, I don't care if it's 2 hours. 1 hour, 2 hours, it don't make no damn difference to me. We'll put those turkeys down like they belong putting down. We weren't trying to beat them tonight. We were playing with those turkeys. And next time they get in the ring with them, we're not going to play with them, baby. We're going to hurt their butts.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Whalen. Little some of us, you know, maybe myself, I've been slacking off in the gym a little bit. So I said to myself, I said, why not I just come out here and exercise tonight? And what I just showed you people was a 60 minutes, me, us, the team, in the ring. And look at us. Look at us. We're still standing. Where are they? Now, I'll tell you what. Next week, there won't be Keith Hart, Bruce Hart, Davey Boy Smith, Robbie Stewart running in at every single time because there's going to be another extra referee.
Oh, good.
Another extra referee, so they can't cheat on us. I'll tell you that right now. So I'm going to tell you something. Next week, we'll all get together later on, and we'll draw straws, and we'll see who we leave lying in a puddle of blood in the center of the ring next week, Mr. Whalen. Next week.
Another referee. Good thing.
Okay, Mr. Stewart, next week, I want you, yes, you, to bring four stretchers down here with you. Four stretchers. One for Boy Smith, Keith Hart, Robbie Stewart. Who's the other one?
Davey Boy.
Oh, Davey Boy Smith. Oh, sorry about that, Mr. Smith. Stu, make it five. One for yourself, baby. Every one of you next week, every single one of you is going to leave this ring on stretchers, bleeding.
Gamma was all finished.
Willen, what do you mean it was all finished?
It was 59-15 when
the bell was rung. There is not a man in professional wrestling today that can put me to sleep in this ring. The only time, Willen, I go to sleep is when I'm at home, sleeping in my bed. John, there's no way.
He wouldn't put Gamma to sleep a week next Sunday.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
That's so good Keith Hart is with a sleeper.
Okay, the very...
And we're going to party tonight, Ed.
Yes, and you're going to let the good times roll, right.
And you won't be invited, you know
good.
That.
Good, I won't
be there.
Because
you don't behave yourself
right.
With my
right.
parties.
Right, J.R. Foley and friends. I don't want to be... I got to tell you something. That 59-minute and 15-second fight was a great one. Only problem was it was supposed to be 60 minutes.
Yeah, we had him beat at the finish there, but... with his fully interfering there,
he rang the bell. I was right beside him.
I think the 90-minute proposition that Davey originally mentioned a while back, right after the match to the referee, is the only way out. If we can, I know we beat them in under 60, but next week I think that'll eliminate any chance whatsoever. It was a learning experience for us tonight, just being in there with the eight men and. I disagreed a lot with the referee's behavior tonight. It was very controversial, but nonetheless, I think we can beat him positively in 90, and if that referee gives us any kind of a break or we can get two referees or something like that, I'm sure that all the cards are in our favor. We're giving away a little bit in size, but I think we got a lot more skill and speed and all the other prerequisites for victory.
Okay, Keith, you had Gamma.
I had him in the sleeper. He was out. He couldn't have lasted another 3 or 4 seconds. Foley rang the bell just to save their bacon. I admit that they gave us a very hard fight in the last few minutes of the match. They were dominating. It breaks my heart to see them kicking the hell out of a great guy like Robbie, and they just can't get away with something like that. No matter what, we're going to get him back, and I think it's going beyond just winning and losing. We got to get even with them, not...
Davey Boy, 90 minutes might do it.
Yeah, I was speaking to Bruce about this match, 90-minute match. We all agreed to a 90-minute match. Robbie agreed.
Keith had him in a sleeper. He was out. All the people seen Foley rang the bell, you know. Foley, Duke Myers, Kerry Brown, and Gamma Singh. They're all one big happy family, you know, but yeah.
Bobby, yeah. How do you feel?
And Hathaway.
Hathaway's there too. How do you feel?
Quite bad. Probably mentally sore rather than physically, although I took a lot of punishment in there, Ed. It hurts me to know that the tactics should go so far as to Foley ringing the bell where they could have been beat. Keith had the sleeper hold on good and well. He had Gamma. It really hurts me mentally that...
Yeah, he was flat, he quit.
It hurts me that they should resort to such tactics, but I took a lot of punishment in there, Ed, but look at me, I'm still standing up.
You're still standing up. Guys, we're right smack out of time. We're looking forward to seeing you next week at the same time. Hope you've enjoyed the show, and in the meantime, in between time, that's it. Another edition of Stampede Wrestling. Bye now.